Hello all. Today, I will be telling you about a dwarf planet in our solar system called 90377 SEDNA, more commonly known as just SEDNA. SEDNA was discovered on November 14th, 2003 by astronomer Michael Brown. He initially nicknamed it after the legendary ghost ship, the Flying Dutchman, because its slow movement had masked its presence from his team prior to its discovery. Shortly after, Brown officially named it SEDNA, after an Inuit goddess, citing that since the object was in the darkest, coldest region of the solar system, the Arctic goddess of the sea would be an appropriate name. This broke precedent, as before this, all objects were numbered prior to being named. The International Astronomical Union did not contest this naming, though, and adhered to Brown's request that all future objects discovered near SEDNA would also be named after Inuit gods and goddesses. SEDNA is a small object. Its diameter is estimated to be between 995 and 1800 kilometers. To put it into perspective, Earth's diameter is around 12,000 kilometers. It gives off a distinct reddish hue, similar to Mars's. The surface composition of SEDNA is primarily methanol, carbon, nitrogen ice, methane ice, and water ice. 70% of SEDNA is methane ice, which could be an attractive source of energy for a future civilization. It is even predicted that SEDNA could host a subsurface liquid water ocean heated by radioactive decay. At its perihelion, the hottest temperature SEDNA reaches does not exceed negative 400 degrees Fahrenheit. A day on SEDNA lasts 10 hours, and a year lasts a staggering 11,400 Earth years. The last time SEDNA was in the same position as it was today, the Holocene era had just begun and humans were coming out of an ice age. SEDNA will reach its perihelion in 76 years, which would be the optimal time to send a probe near it. SEDNA moves through space at a little over 1 kilometer per second. It was thought at one point to have a moon, but no such moon was found. SEDNA's orbit is very eccentric, with its aphelion putting it at the inner edge of the Oort cloud. Some scientists believe that SEDNA did not originate in the solar system, but was captured from a passing brown dwarf star. Should one stand on the surface of SEDNA, they could block out the sun's light with a pin. Thank you all for your attention, and Deutsch sprechen Günther.